Hey guys, here is a simple project for a toiletry bag. It makes a brilliant gift around holiday season. You can see a matching handbag in the photo. This one I have used the pattern of Britannia, but sewn in a 1.5 inch base, so it looks like a different shape, but actually the pattern is still the same. If you want me to make a tutorial with a quilted bag, let me know. I will do one shortly. So let's get started with this project. Let's go through what we need to complete this project. Here I have two layers of the pocket and there's two layers of lining. I have got a zipper very much longer than what I need, but we're going to trim it to the length we need. I've also got a little bias binding tape that's going to go on the edge, two ends of my zipper tape. I've also got less than a meter of bias binding that will go edging on the pocket. Before we go ahead, we just need to make sure that this quilted fabric is cut right. I've already quilted the fabric. If you keep the pattern on top, you will see that it's a little bit extra all around. When you try and quilt like this, please make sure you have the fabric extra. Otherwise, it's just going to go kind of out of shape if you cut fabric first and then quilt it. Okay, so let me place it like so and then cut both the quilted layers of fabric. So that will form the main part of this toiletry bag. Okay, here we have two layers of lining, two layers of quilted main fabric. We're gonna first work on the pockets. Basically, just take your pockets. Your pockets are slightly wider than your main fabric panel because we're going to pleat it somewhere in the center, like two tiny pleats on either side, and make two divisions or three divisions on your pocket. We're going to fold this into half and just edge the binding to the edge of the pocket fabric, like so. Just fold the binding like so, hold it in the center, and then go and sew the binding onto the fabric. This is your lining fabric. Now, from this edge here, you need to make a line marking 1 inch away from that edge, like so. Now go and place your pocket fabric on that line and sew a 1/2 inch stitch. When you're sewing, we're going to make a little tiny pleat there and then another tiny pleat here. So that's something that you can make just as you go along and when you're sewing. If you find it difficult, just go ahead and pin it on the two pleats and align it with the line mark that we have made and go and sew a straight stitch. My fabric is aligned on the mark, so I'm just going to make a little pleat. This is a join that I've made on the fabric because I didn't have enough fabric, but you could just take a straight fabric. Now I go ahead and match the side seams like so, and then make another pleat. This is the line we have just sewn. Turn this over and we're gonna go and match the side seams and just do a stay stitch right at the edge of the fabric. Same way, another stay stitch right at the edge of the fabric. We're also going to iron this and get a crease line. So we can go and sew a line next to these pleats that will create your pockets. So I'm just going to keep it like that and keep my pleat and iron it. The same way, I'm just going to keep it like so. Keep my pleat and iron it so it is flat. If you wish to create more compartments and more room, all you have to do is take this a little extra and you can create another pleat and you can go and sew as many compartments as you need. I'm just placing my needle next to the pleat, so it's not catching the pleat, it is right next to the pleat. So now I've gone and attach the side seams. We're just doing an edge stitch so the fabric catches to the edge, and this will all be covered when we close your side seams. We now have both the patterns ready. We need to now go ahead and prepare the zipper. So now we're going to go and measure the main fabric, or you could even measure your pattern. And go and measure from the beginning till the end, and it's measuring about 12 inches. We're going to go and sew a half an inch stitch, so that leaves us about 11 and a half. But I would like it to be 10 and a half just to be on the safer side. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut the zipper to 10 and a half inches. Okay, that is the beginning of your zipper, so I'm going to take about half an inch from there and cut that off. And now turn it over. Now measure your 10 and a half inches right from the start till the end, like here. Not from the beginning of your zipper puller, but the beginning of the tape where we have just cut off the little extra. We're going to go and mark 10 and a half inches and then cut this straight across. If you need to, go ahead and mark it just so that you get it straight. So now we need to go and bind the edges with a bias binding, because that is going to be the finished size of a zipper. So basically hold it like so, fold it into half and go and sew this edge and also this edge. Before we go and sew at the beginning, we just need to make sure this is kind of opening wide. We don't want it to be wide, we need it to be straight, the same width of the zipper. What I normally do is I go and do a little hand tacking stitch so this holds in place. I'm going to place it like so and hold it. Same way, we're going to bind the other end. It's going to be a lot more easier doing the other one. That's how the zipper looks. Just trim the edges so it's neat and straight. Same way, we're going to go and just neaten the edges. These are the two main panels. The zipper, we have just kind of edge binded it. Let's go ahead and sew it onto the main panel. So flip this over and make sure the zipper is centered, which means you have equal amounts on either side, like so. And go and sew a straight stitch, just a quarter inch stitch. I'm going to start a little bit away from the puller because later on we're going to go and close it. Just find it easier to do it like this. So just go and sew a quarter inch stitch. That's how the zipper looks. Now we're going to flip this one over like so. And match the side seams, because that's very important. By matching the side seams, we're just going to bring this down like so, place it like so, and go and start from here and going as close to the zipper puller. Later on, we're going to push the zipper puller away from here and go and sew these two stitches. That's how it looks. Now turn, and that's how it looks from the back. Now we're going to turn this over and place one of the linings like so and place it like that. Again, match the sides of both the panels and go and sew on top of the same stitch we have sewn from here to here. The zipper pull apart, we're going to go and close later on all of them together. I'm aligning my lining to the edge of the main fabric so they're sewn in together properly. That's the front and that is the back of one side of the lining. Now we need to go and place the other side of the lining like so and place it like that. Again, go and match the side seams and go and sew on top of from here till, as you can see, the stitching on the top. So let's go ahead and sew on top of the same stitching. We're going to stop where we started. Now lift your presser foot up, open this up like so, and then push your zipper tape away So now you can just go and sew neatly all of the fabric together. All the way till the end. Again, we are going to open the side which was not closed here, and now the zipper tape is away, we're just going to go and close that seam. Both the main panels and the lining is attached to the zipper, and that's how it looks. And the zipper is neatly sandwiched in between the two layers of the main fabric and the lining. One of the problems is when you have the lining close to the zipper, it always tends to catch the teeth when you open and close the zipper. So let's go ahead and push the allowance like so and put a top stitch on the lining from the beginning till the end. We're going to go quite at the edge. You can use an edge binding foot, but I prefer to use a normal foot, then I can see where I'm sewing. And I'm pulling the fabric as I go along. We've sewn the top stitch on one side. We turn around and hold the allowance like so towards your right hand side and go and sew top stitch on the other side as well. Top stitching is done on both the sides. Now we need to go and close the bag. So let's open it like that and match your joins on the side seam and place a pin here, and then go ahead and sew a stitch starting and finishing with a back stitch from here to here. Same way, we're going to close the bottom as well on the polywadding side and the other side seam. When we come to the lining side, when we come to the base of the lining, we're going to leave about 3 or 4 inches gap here and only sew from here to here and here to here. Just so that we are sure about what we're doing, I'm just going to center the bottom line and make a center mark. And then starting from here, I'm going to keep it at 2.5 inches. So the opening will be about 5 inches in the center. So let's go ahead and close the bottom of the lining from here to here, jump, and then from here to here. We're starting on the side seam and we're going to go and sew a 1/2 inch stitch. Then we're going to sew on the bottom. Just hold your fabric together and sew a 1/2 inch stitch. We're now sewing on the other side. We're now sewing on the bottom of the lining. So stop at the marking and then we're going to jump to the other one. That's how it looks from the front and the back. And now we need to go and try to open the seams. So keep it to a medium iron because your wadding is nylon and it's very prone to heat. So give it a try in low heat and try to open the seams because that will give you neat finish. We're going to open the seams all around. Okay, my seams are now open. So we're going to go and match the two corners this way, the lining and the main fabric. Just hold the corners like so. And match the seam to seam, side seam to the bottom seam. And now we're going to bring this together. Before you do that, just make sure you go inside like that and then open your zipper. If your zipper is not open, we won't be able to turn this properly. So just go ahead and open your zipper from inside. Okay, the zipper is now open. Once the zipper is open, it's easier to kind of put this together. So you're going to bring these two corners like so and then hold them together and go and sew a half an inch stitch, starting and finishing with a back stitch. The same way, we're going to go and attach these two corners as well. Okay, those are the two corners. We're going to go and sew a half an inch stitch. Just align them to match the edges properly. Okay, that's how it looks when you close both the corners. Now open this little gap here. Now we need to turn everything inside out. Just take your time to do this, because it's not going to be done in a hurry, and don't rip the seams apart in a hurry. So take your time, it will all come out. Now we're going to go and hold this fold at the bottom of the bag of the lining, and just go and do a top stitch, starting and finishing with a back stitch. This is the bottom of the lining I'm going to close. Basically hold it like so and start and finish with a back stitch. Just go and do an edge stitch. I've left my thread in red so you can see the stitch neatly. So I'm going to go. Okay, that is the base of the bag we have just sewn in, and that's the seam we closed. Now turn this all over. Once you push the sides properly, you can see that this is sitting without any problem and it has got a base. Close this, and your beautiful and cute toiletry bag is now ready. You can go ahead, if you want to add more decorations, then you can go and add another zipper pocket here. You can add a little tab and a label. This is just a basic version, and go and make this your own by adding final finishing touches. Thank you for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I will see you in the next project. Bye bye for now.